Well, ladies and gentlemen, we are here at Kyalami. It is the Formula Dream season back once again, season two. We are here and we are thrilled to be bringing this coverage to you live from Kyalami. It's a 1967 layout. I'm Kyle Tupper. Alongside me is Noah Nadu. Noah, say a couple words for me.
I'm so excited to get into this season with you, Kyle. It's going to be so much fun, especially with a few new teams here. It's going to be awesome.
Yeah, I am super, super excited to get going here with the Formula Dream season. And what better track to get it going? Last year, we started the season at Interlagos. It was a good race, but it wasn't a great race. It wasn't anything special, I wouldn't say. And we decided we'd switch those races around. We'd go to Kyalami first and then Interlagos for the second race of the season. And this track just produces some absolutely brilliant racing. So we will go ahead and back away here for just a minute and allow you all to take in the sights and sounds of Formula Dream. With that, we will be right back. Well, like we said, we're here getting ready to go at Kyalami. It's Jedi John on pole position as it stands with 5.5 minutes left in qualifying. Once again, I'm Kyle Tupper, and alongside me is Noah Nadu. We are your commentary team today from Kyalami, and likely for the rest of the year, we may have a couple guests joining us from time to time. But until then, it's just going to be us two that you're stuck with. So, Noah, what are your outlooks for this season? What are you thinking so far?
Oh, for the season, I'm excited for the new team area, consisting of Steve Durham, Spencer Brown, and Casey Lakatis. They have a lot of experience in racing, so I think they're going to be very strong this year.
They do. I'm definitely looking forward to some good pace from them. I'm also interested to see what we get out of Inter-Europol competition. They've got some really good names on that team. Lots of guys that have raced a lot in their time here in the Central United community and outside of the Central United community as well. So, it's definitely going to be something to look out for, these guys. I think they're going to have a lot of pace. They've got a good car setup, too, IEC does. So I'm really looking forward to what they're going to be able to create out on the track for us. Noah, what do you have as far as an outlook for what their car setup looks like for the year?
For you're talking about for Area iRacing?
For IEC and Area. I want to hear both of them. I want to hear your thoughts on how that's going to affect their performance this year.
Well, so Area went for top speed and pit crew. So they're going to have a strong pit crew this season. It's going to help them a lot because we've seen last season some pit stops really affect the race. People getting long stops and then some close battles got really ruined by someone taking too long in the pits. So Aria going with a strong pit crew is really going to help them.
Yeah, I would definitely agree with that. IEC, on the other hand, they're just going to be a really bad fast team, I think. No, any insights on them?
Yeah, they're just going to be very balanced, and they went for fuel saving. So we saw last season, too, a couple of one-stops win the race because someone didn't have to pit twice like some other teams had to. So that's going to be very interesting between, I think, the two new teams to see how they turn out.
Yes, indeed. Should be very interesting from start to finish here today at Kyalami. So we'll go ahead and head over to our roster screen. Definitely looking like an interesting roster. We'll run you through these real quick. So first of all, for the new boys, Area iRacing, they've got Spencer Brown, Casey Licatus, and Steve Durham rounding out their field. For Blue Balls Motorsport, all three drivers returning for them, Colin LaFleabag, Josh Fobo, and Bot Brook. As for Central United, they've got Kyle Tuffer, Noah Nadeau, and James Brown in their lineup. James Brown, an unexpected returner for them. We did not expect to see him come back for another season. He had a rough one last year, so we're a little surprised to see him coming back. But hopefully he'll be able to make a better mark on Formula Dream than he did last time around. It was a rough last season for Central United as a whole as well. And for Inter-Europol, we've got Michal Lukwinski, Jafet Barahona, and Juno Maksimovic. Should be a strong lineup there. If you want to take us through the rest of them, Noah, actually, I'll take that myself. I don't know if you've got this graphic pulled up. We've got Milk Mono Motors with Madison Brown, Hayden Segovis, and Jedi John. Precum Racing, the team champions of last year, with Felice Zivielo, Coral, and Will Duncan. As for Rocket Racing, they came second in the Constructors Championship last year. They got Marcelo Mars, David Lakers, and Jeffrey J-Man. And then you've got Shreve Hart Racing with Mallory Fonte, Alex Martin, and Keelan Wynn in their lineup. So should be a very interesting season. We've got a lot of returning drivers and also a lot of new drivers as well. So we should have a really good mix of things going on there. I'm really excited for that. I don't know about you, Noah, but should be a really fun season.
Large grid this year, so it's going to be a lot of fun.
Definitely a very large grid. So here's our pole sitter. It's Jeffrey J-Man. He's looked really good out there so far today. Didn't expect Rocket Racing to be topping the timing tables as well as they are, but we've got a really diverse top 10 here in terms of teams. Gonna be
and really
very
only
interesting.
2 seconds separating the whole field.
Yeah, really a very close qualifying. We've got a minute and 10 seconds left. We know Formula Dream's always going to be close racing, but it's a really close list of people here. Here's Coral, driver we expected to be a lot quicker. PCR, a team we expected to be a lot quicker, as we'll have him take us around a lap of Kyalami. Noah, do you have any experience with this track? I know we called it last year. I just want to know if you have any wisdom to offer about what kind of setup works well here, what kind of driving style works well. We'll just see if you have anything to offer.
Judging from last year, it's just you want to have a decent amount of speed going through the straights, but you really need a good balanced car, which I think ICR in the Interpol would have a good car for this track, just because you do need to be really balanced for this sort of track.
Yeah, I would definitely agree with that. It's a tough track. It's a tricky track. Lots of corners, but also a big long straight. Most of the overtaking will take place at the end of that main straight into turn number one. That's where most of the actual carnage will be happening. So that's definitely something to watch out for, is that first turn as Coral is coming down to that final straight right now. Lots of slipstreaming, lots of drafting, and they will be extremely close all the way through the lap here as Coral is going to come across the line here, seeing if he can improve out of 21st. No, he can't. He actually goes slower than he did before. So a good looking top 10. Jeffrey J-Man, definitely an unexpected one up there. Didn't expect to see Rocket Racing be quite that quick at this track. Jedi John trying to make an impact here out of P2. See if he can hop up a couple positions here. I guess it will.
I remember last season, Rocket Racing got off to a very hot start before they fell off mid-season toward the end.
Yes, they sure did have a hot start, and Jedi John had a rough season until the very end as well. He got that big win at the Nordschleife with Keelan Wynn crashing out in the last corner. That is probably an all-time classic race, as John isn't able to go any quicker that time around. We'll see, as Bot Brook has just crossed the line as well. So has David Lakers. Casey Licata is coming through as well. Here comes Kyle Tupper in 24th position. We'll see if he's able to improve. He was quickest in practice, but not so much so
here in
qualifying session. No, not great.
And he goes back to pits.
Indeed, he does go back to pits. So we will go ahead and run you through our starting order here from Kyalami. We are ready to get racing. It's a 45 lap event. Weather looking fine. It's not looking great, but it's looking just good enough to get some good racing in here today. So, as we look through the order, in pole position is the Rocket Racing car of Jeffrey J-Man. Should be an exciting result for him. In second is Jedi John, looking to have a strong start to his season after a disappointing season last year. Factor Bacon rounding out in third, ahead of his teammate, Factor J, who's all the way down the order, actually, down in 11th. And in third, Factor Bacon. Fourth is Mallory Fonte of Shreve Heart Motors, so four different teams represented in the top four before we get our first repeat, which is Madison Brown, starting in fifth position. In sixth is the Area iRacing newcomer team of Spencer Brown and Hayden Segovis in seventh for Luchex MMM. In eighth is the second Area iRacing driver, is Casey Lakatis. In ninth is Marcelo Mars, and in tenth is Michal Litwinski. In 11th place is the team Factor of Factor J, and then we've got IEC in 12th and 3rd, Jafeth Barahona and Juno Maksimovic, two drivers to keep an eye on today as they could easily pour through the field with that fuel-saving mechanism that they've got that could be an excellent difference maker. If you want to take us through the rest of the order, starting with position 14, Noah, it's all yours.
Yeah, starting in P14, we have Felice Zviello. Starting 15th, the first finisher for him come racing is Noah Naidu. Starting 16th would be Keelan Wynn, followed by Alex Martin. Starting 18th would be the newcomer, Steve Durham, followed by David Lakers. Starting 20th is Colonel Fleabag. 21st is Kroll. 22nd, Bot Brook. 23rd, also from Central United, is James Brown, followed by his teammate, Kyle Tupper. 25th is Josh Fobo. And 26th is Will Duncan.
All right, so that's how our lineup is going to look for race one of the Formula Dream season. It's exciting. We've got some shakeups happening here. Not the order we expected to have at all. Definitely some big twists and turns in here that we probably didn't quite expect. Other than that, Noah, do you have any comments to make before we get rolling here?
Oh, I'm ready to get the season started.
I'm also excited to get this season started as they're all lined up on the grid, stacked up here at Kyalami. We're about to get the lights up and about to get the lights out. As we are going to get underway here, we've got 45 laps from Kyalami, South Africa, as the lights going up. And we are underway here, taking a look at the back of the grid. The season two of Formula Dream is underway. The curtains have been drawn to the side. Jedi John has gotten a great start. He's out in front of Jeffrey J-Man here, heading into turn one as we watch the back of the pack roll by without any incident as they pour into turn one. Still leading the way, it's Jeffrey J-Man taking the inside. And he's managed to survive so far and jump into first place. Factor Bacon in second, Jedi John down in third. As it stands,
in a couple of movements, Kyle Tupper fell from 24th to 26th on that opening little scramble. Noah Naidu went up from 14th to 13th. Keelan Wynn up to 17th.
Yeah, very interesting to look at as the gap to first, 7 seconds separating first to last place here. Kyle Tupper really fell down the order there. Very sad to see for the Central United camp, as James Brown has just lost a position to Steve Durham, as we'll take a closer look at the order here as it begins to stack up. We've got some good racing going on in the back and in the middle. Good racing going on just about everywhere.
Everywhere.
Actually.
Yeah, everyone's pretty packed up right now. Not too many big gaps.
Yeah, very rarely do we see bad racing here in Formula Dream. It's the fastest lap set by Jeffrey J-Man of Rocket Racing. Good looking lap for him.
And Mars just got by Madison Brown from got up to sixth position.
Yes, he did, as we're taking a look at the leaders now, but we can look down the pack now as Barahona losing a position to Hayden Segovis, who moves up into the top 10. Barahona going to try and battle that one back. I think we've got three IECs in a row. Barahona, Litwinski, and Maksimovic all lined up 1, 2, and 3 in 11th, 12th, and 13th position. Mallory Fonte really knocking on the door of Factor Bacon now, as they are side by side. Actually, it's Jedi John that are going at it with Mallory Fonte. And Fonte's going to take the inside up into third for the Shreve Heart driver.
A
poor season last year. Got gifted a win at the Canadian Grand Prix, Mallory Fonte did, but never actually outright finished first. in any race. That one was due to a technicality, but she is absolutely setting the pace here as it's hopping up over the curb. She's flying side by side with Factor Bacon down the straight. Bacon pushes her to the inside. Is Fonte going to be able to have the grip and hold on down the main straight here? She's got more pace in her car than the Team Factor car does. And Jeffrey Jayman continues to set the fastest lap. It's a 110.0, but Fonte is ahead here and is going to have
about the
inside.
Fast lap.
Mallory Fonte does indeed set the fastest lap by a couple of tenths as we go into the middle of the pack here. A big lockup from Marcelo Mars going down the inside of Spencer Brown. Ooh. And a big send from Mars, but I think he's going to hold on to it as that's a huge lunge. But
wow,
he's
and he hit the curb.
He did hit the curb, and Brown looking up the outside now. Man, we've got nothing but action going on here at Kyalami so far. It's great stuff so far as we take a look at some of the people that we've seen on stream here. Will Duncan. Not a whole lot doing, trying to get past Bot Brook here in the back, but it's just not happening.
At the very start.
Fonte is barnstorming. She's shaved about 0.3 seconds off of J-Man's lead already here at the start. It's an unbelievable drive from her so far, and she does only have 5 laps of fuel left in the tank, so definitely got a lighter load to start here. It's going to be a 2 or 3 stop race. For IEC, it might end up being a 2-stop race, which would be huge. As well as the other fuel-saving teams, they might be able to shorten it to a 2-stop, which would be great. And it's a 109.9. We've entered the 109s here. An excellent lap from Mallory Fonte there as she's getting ever closer to J-Man. As you see, the lap times progressively get slower down the field, but Fonte still inching ever closer. The gap really shrinking here. Can't quite say that this is what we expected to see when we loaded up the Formula Dream season here, but it's a good outcome for the Shreveport camp.
At least Zviello is starting to fall off a bit. He was up to 13th, now back to 18th.
Very unfortunate for Zviello there, as we'll go on board with him. He is knocking on the door of David Lakers. He's got a couple cars in sight. You never really lose sight of those cars in front of you here at Kyalami. And luckily we've gotten through the first few laps unscathed. We're on lap 4 already. Haven't had any incidents, no contact, which is a rarity here in Formula Dream if you're here for long enough to see the kind of things that go on here. But we do see quite a few incidents usually. But yeah, we've managed to avoid anything major so far. As we take a look here at Zviello. Oh, running out wide up there is Keelan Wynn. Maybe that's going to be pounced on as the lap times continue to shrink for Fonte. It's a 109.7. She is absolutely roaring as you hear that
Casey
engine of the PCR roaring to life. That's the Ferrari F2004 engine. As we see a battle down the inside up here, I think it's Keelan Wynn sending it down the inside of Nadu. And he takes a position from Nadu. Maximovic as well, up a spot on Hayden Segovis.
Potentially United cars are struggling out there today.
Well, unfortunately, it's seeming to be more of the same from last season for Central United, as they did not have a great previous season. As we're hearing over the radio scanners, Marcelo Mars is getting the call for the first pit stop of the race. So Mars is going to head in here on lap number 5. That's probably going to end up being a 3-stop strategy then for Mars and Rocket Racing. As Fonte, we looked away for a while. She's taken the lead. She has taken the lead,
wow.
And she's almost a second up on Jeffrey J-Man. However, J-Man's got 55 liters of fuel in that tank. Fonte, looking at it, only has 10, so she's going to have to come in pretty soon. It's a 108! She's taken a second off that previous lap time. Mallory Fonte is absolutely tearing up the track right now.
She is 2 seconds faster than J-Man in second.
As Mars into the pits now, getting that service done, dropping positions rapidly here. As Ludwinski is who we're watching now. Barahona has gotten a position from Jay. IEC is charging on track right now. Japheth Barahona up into position 7 ahead of the previous year's champion, Factor J, as I believe Marcelo Mars should be getting back on track here. Yeah, it's going to be a lonely drive for Mars. And they've only put 6 laps of fuel into that tank. Yeah, I think it was a very bad call. They put 6 laps in, so they're going to give him a short stint here, give him some fresh tires, and just have him try to make up as much ground as he can to see if they can beat everybody else that's on the 3-stop strategy. As we're hearing, Coral is also getting the call, so an interesting call by PCR, but Mars is going to have some competition there, as Coral is going to be coming on in this lap, according to our radio scanners. So many close gaps throughout the field here. The middle of the pack is just absolutely excellent to watch right now. We've got Hayden Segovis trying to mount a charge on Juno Maksimovic. But maybe more interestingly is Maksimovic on Casey Lakatis here, as she dives to the inside. Maybe or maybe not. It might just be too far to be within striking distance unless we're going to see a big lunge here. Oh, Maksimovic down the inside on Lakatis, and a big send. Lakatis leaves the room. Great move by Juno there, and now it is 9th and 10th for Litwinski and Maksimovic. And Jafeth Barahona as well in 7th position. A good day for IEC so far.
Will Duncan up to 24th now, so yep. Up two positions in the day.
Yep, so Will Duncan has passed the pitters. Kyle Tupper up into 21st. He's had a little bit of a charge after not a great start. Mallory Fonte, the leader, getting the pit call. So it's going to be an early stop as well for Sharif Hart. We knew it was coming. But here come the first of the pitters for this leading pack. It's going to be Fonte in. That'll give J-Man the lead back. As it'll be interesting to see where Fonte is going to come out here as she enters pit lane, loses a couple positions already. You see the indicator says she's down into third place, down into fifth even. Now sixth, seventh.
Yeah, she's falling pretty fast.
Falling further and further down.
It'd probably come out around 18th, now around 180, maybe? That's depending on how good the kid is done.
A good guess as Nadu now is roaring on past the pit lane. Fonte is going to be even further back than that. It's going to be a battle maybe with Will Duncan from Allie Fonte as we see.
Brooke
down the inside. Hold that thought, Noah. Down the inside of her teammate. Calling a flea bag, grabbing a position there. Not a great day for Blue Balls Motorsport so far, but teammates are scrapping with each other at the very least. James Brown up at 18th. 18th is not as bad of a result this year as it would have been last year with 26 cars on the grid now.
For sure. Yeah, Central United seems to be like sticking 16, 18. They seem to be pretty far back in the pack so far, so I mean, they need to work things out.
Yeah, it does seem to be so. At least up to this point for Central United. As it's
for the two new teams.
Yeah. Interestingly enough, Factor Bacon starting to mount a bit of a charge on Jeffrey J-Man here. Still got some very close racing up in the front. Factor J has really tumbled down. He was running pretty well earlier, but now he's really under threat from Litwinski. And Maksimovic not too far behind. So IEC definitely really trying to mount something here. They did not have the most, you know, scintillating qualifying. They were solid, but they weren't anything special. But they are really starting to step it up here in the race. Excellent race pace. As Nadu falls down the order even more, Felice Zivielo up in the 16th for PCR.
Yeah, I was going to say, the two new teams are very strong. We have Spencer Brown in third. Interpol is making their push. And Casey in 11th. So both of the new teams are looking very strong out here on the grid.
Absolutely. And interestingly enough, our champions from last year, not quite the same scenario for them. They are way down the order. We've got Coral in 26th, Will Duncan in 23rd, and Felice Zivielo in 16th. So PCR, definitely a day to forget for them so far. Maybe they have a fuel strategy call that's going to work out a certain way for them. Here's a quiet racer we've had, Hayden Segovis in 10th place. He's getting the call to box. So here comes a pit stop for MILF Mommy Motors. We'll see how that turns out for them. As Segovis is going to roll on into the pit lane, we see our pit lane timer come up there.
He might fall all the way to the back.
There's a good chance he could tumble all the way down to the back. Would not be all that surprising, as ignore me while I move our pit lane timer so it's more visible to our fans watching from home. Anybody who's not in the stands is Yasikovas having a very long stop here. We'll see if he's able to come out ahead of Coral. 5 seconds,
and this exact
6 seconds,
reason
7
right
seconds,
here.
It continues to tick. He must be getting a lot of fuel put into that car. Or maybe
this is the exact reason I said Area made the good choice with the pit crew upgrade, because this is the exact situation that you can get into and you just ruin your race.
Absolutely. Do we have a problem with Hayden Segovis here? This is interesting for sure. Segovis sitting in the pit lane. Now he finally comes out. Holy cow, what a long stop.
That right there is the reason why I thought Area made one of the best decisions that they could have made.
That's a poor stop for Hayden Segovis, but they just put 44 laps of fuel into his tank. Hayden Segovis is now fueled to the end. Looking at our list here, nobody has as much fuel in the tank as Hayden Segovis does. So,
It's interesting, but he's almost a lap down.
He is close to a lap down. Does anyone else in the field have enough fuel to go to the end as Marsh comes into the pit lane?
But the only thing is, he's so far down, they might be able to get a pit with just enough fuel to finish the race and still be up like 10 seconds on him.
You know, they might be, but I think it got mentioned in the chat here. I think Hayden Segovis got fueled up enough that he's going to last the whole race at Interlagos without having to put new fuel in the tank.
Yeah, he's pretty fueled.
And now, here he is. He's in front of the leaders. He's stacking up the leaders here, giving Factor Bacon a chance to strike on Jeffrey Jayman. He's got a very heavy car with all that new fuel in it, but you're right. He is almost an entire lap down. But here, with some cars still needing to stop twice, and Segovis not having to stop at all anymore, did he make a good call here? I guess it'll only be time to tell. You also have to think about the tires. Everybody runs a hard compound tire here in Formula Dream, so there are no two different compounds as J-Man is going to lap Hayden Segovis here. He moves to the outside. Oh, big slide there from J-Man. Sorry, go ahead, Noah.
Okay, there's also teams that haven't pitted yet, and they could also fuel to the end and be less heavy than he is and come out in a better position. So I think if he was going to do that, he should have waited a little bit longer.
Yeah.
But
I would agree. Yeah, definitely. There is some viability in that two-stop strategy. Great racing here up the front, by the way. This is incredible. First place through sixth place, none of them are more than a second from each other.
So yeah, it's been awesome.
Are absolutely going at it. Crockpot asks how his fuel is looking. Will Duncan's got 38 liters in the tank. He's got 12 laps left in said tank of fuel. As we'll take a look at our pit count here on the scoreboard. Just looking through the order here. We've got one stop from the leader, J-Man, and from Bacon. No stops from Spencer Brown. One from Japheth Barahona. Brown, Jane Lewinsky have all stopped. Keelan Lynn has made a stop. Fobo and Brown have also come into the pits, as has Kyle Tupper, Fonte, Fleabag, Duncan, and Coral. And Marcin Segovis had made two stops, actually, now, which is interesting to see. As we've got Coral about to come in for his second stop, we saw that he only fueled for a short stint, so we knew he was going to have to come in again.
I think the Kyle Tupper one, does he have fuel? Because I think that might have been, like, he might have got close to pits, but not actually went in, because he's up to 17th now, unless he...
You might be right, Noah. There's a good chance that Kyle Tupper just found himself creeping on in towards the pit commit line as Barahona is under fire from John here. We usually don't see overtaking on this part of the track, but the MMM drivers are swarming in behind Japheth Barahona, and they are very impatient with each other. As, oh, look, running way wide there in the back was Madison Brown. That was ugly from Brown. She ran all the way out into the gravel trap. Scary stuff there as Coral pitting out of 25th place. So I'm not sure what he's hoping for. Maybe hoping the whole field crashes out in front of him. We'd hope that he would be fueling to the end. And now I think you're very right. It's another short stop for Coral. Is he going to try and make this a four stop?
It's happened before. So
yeah, we've seen teams come in. We've also seen teams come in for absolutely insane amounts of fuel. And now you've got the same thing happening for Coral. He's stacking up the leaders in front. Look at the big slide from those Rocket Racing cars. They sacrifice a lot of aero with that top speed setup that they've got. You see such a huge slide every time Jeffrey J-Man comes through that first corner, but it's worked out for him pretty well, as you can see, as we do have Tupper now into the pit lane as he tumbles down the positions. But yeah, here in Formula Dream, we've definitely seen teams pit four or five times sometimes in the same race, and it doesn't always work out all that badly. Sometimes it can work out for him pretty decently, as Segovis is still in last place, but he's also lumped in with this pack of leaders here too, as Barahona has gotten past Brown. Once again, on a place of the track where you don't see a whole lot of overtaking happening. So, Noah, we're well into the race now as the sun starts to set just a little bit here at Kyalami. We have some cooling weather as the clouds continue to roll in as well. From partly cloudy to almost fully cloudy here. But, Noah, any thoughts on the race so far? Anything that's piqued your interest or that you think we might be missing?
Spencer Brown has been very strong today, up to P4 for Area, which has been very impressive for his first race with the Formula Dream.
Yes, it is his first race in Formula Dream. This would be a great result. Oh, is this going to be a double overtake here? Oh, there's contact! It's Barahona! And he has sent Coral spiraling into the gravel trap, and he's beached. I don't think he's going to get out, so there's the crash. There's the crash that we were wondering if it was going to happen. So does Barahona have damage then? Is going
to
be a big question.
He has to have at least some. but...
Yeah, we'll have to take a look at Japheth Barahona's car as Coral seems to be stuck in the gravel trap. Maybe a little bit of retribution. Not really necessary from a new driver like Barahona, who's in third. But maybe a little retribution for
that's
Coral,
really unfortunate
for Coral you know. Knocking Colin Fleabag out of the race at Monza last year. I don't know. Maybe just a little
It really
bit,
is
so.
Heartbreak for Pico, as Crockpot says. The champions last season just not off to a good start here this season.
Yeah, no, it's not been a good race, although Will Duncan's not doing too bad up there. Japheth Barahona, now we look at him, taking a look at his car just to see if there's any real damage to it. It doesn't look to be too banged up. The rear wing looking okay. I'm not seeing much of a problem there. The front wing does look a little bit scuffed, I will say, for Barahona, but sometimes... at this track, it's not a bad thing to lose a little bit of aero. It makes you a little more slippery down the straights, and if you don't lose too much, you can still be pretty quick. So we're on lap number 16. We're going to have two pitters come in here. James Brown getting the call, as is Marcelo Mars, as Brown is in the pit lane now as we speak. Here comes
he was up to 15th.
Call.
Not bad for James Brown.
He was. He was indeed, but I think this is one of his first stops, if not the first stop.
I think
Brown.
This is indeed a first stop.
Yeah, we'll take a look at our pit numbers here. James Brown, it does say it's his second stop, but I don't think he actually came in. He must have crossed the pit commit line going for an overtake on the straight.
Very similar to Kyle Tepper.
Yep. So Brown did get a pretty solid amount of fuel. He's got 19 laps to put into that tank. Not going to be enough to go to the end, but it's going to be enough to make it a solid three-stop race for him. Interestingly enough, I'd like to look at the IEC pit counts. That is very interesting. Litwinski, he's got one listed, but I don't know if he came in. Don't know
I think
if he did.
Any of those guys up front came in.
I don't think many of them have. I think J-Man, did he go in for a stop? No, I don't think he did, actually, not thinking about it.
He didn't. He did it to Spencer Brown. I don't think 1-5 have, at
I
least.
I don't think so either. So interesting to see, we know that IEC are one of the prominent teams that chose fuel saving as their strategy this year, as Phobo now has brought it into the box. IEC chose fuel saving as their strategy, and it's probably going to work out really well for them. This should easily be a two-stop for them when it comes down to it, and that might put them in a very good chance to maybe even grab a race win here. I think J-Man's probably going to have to go in again. Now, Segovis is not. We pointed that out. He'll be able
he's
to
so
gain
far down.
At least a few positions, I would think. But, I mean, just looking at the
he's
timing tables.
He
is 74 seconds behind. But 1 through 19 are all pretty close to each other, I must say. Positions 40. 1 through 19.
But here's the thing. Even if they do lose the 20 seconds on their pit stop, say in P20 with James Brown, he'll still be almost 10 seconds down.
We'll just have to wait for it to play out. As we talked about Spencer Brown not pitting yet, he is getting the call now as he's going to come on in. See how good of a stop Spencer Brown can get here as he falls down into 8th position for Area iRacing. Ugly looking pit stop. I promise you he didn't actually get damaged there. As you hear that engine waiting to roll to life here.
Thought they had quick pit stops. Maybe he's going to the end. We'll have to see.
You would assume he would be fueling to the end here. They do have an increased pit crew effectiveness. We'll see how much they decided to put on in there. Yep, so he's got 34 laps of fuel. He will be set to the end. That's a great stop then, considering the circumstances.
How much fuel they put in.
Brown.
Yeah.
That's a very quick stop to put in that amount of fuel. He's still in 19th. He comes out in front of James Brown. And
he's in
that
threshold
is...
where the pit stop will put him right in the top three again from the other guys.
Indeed. So,
so
yeah, Spencer Brown... not Spencer Brown. Apologies. Steve Durham is who we were looking at earlier. Talking for a while about him, too. But yeah, Spencer Brown was prominent all race. We were waiting for him to go in. Steve Durham as well, we got a little notification that said he was in a good battle, but doesn't appear to be so much so anymore. Coral has gotten back out. He took it back to the pits and limped it on back. Maybe got
good
the spare
him.
Car going. So good for him for getting going, at least trying to salvage some points for PCR, not to get a DNF and lose half points. But it's not going to be a great day as we're coming up to half distance here. So we haven't talked a whole lot about Jeffrey J-Man. We also haven't talked a whole lot about these leaders in general, these top three. But Barahona is very close to J-Man, and you're starting to see a lot of tire fall off from J-Man. And as I say that, we see the name blink red for Jeffrey J-Man. That means he's getting the pit call. So the leader going to pit in here And it will be a triumphant day for IEC as they're going to lead laps for their first time ever in Formula Dream. It's going to be Japheth Barahona leading Inter-Europol competition into their first lap led here in Formula Dream. So an exciting moment for them and for that team. They definitely deserve it. They've put together a very strong car setup.
It's exciting to see the new teams do so well.
Definitely.
Right away.
J-Man and Bacon, P2 and P3, both into the pits. Jedi John has had a bit of a quiet race, but he's back up to second. We knew he was going to be pretty solid. Will Duncan here getting the call for PCR. He's found his way back up into 17th place. Coral also getting a pit stop call, which is interesting considering his car just got beached.
In pits, but yeah, that's okay.
They probably just sent it on the spare car with whatever fuel it had in it, and I'm guessing it wasn't very much. That's probably how it ended up going.
It's like qualifying amount. That's crazy.
Sure does seem like it was a qualifying car that they sent him out in. As here's Litwinski giving a little bit of a battle to last year's champion Factor J, who wasn't necessarily champion because of blinding pace all the time, but just because of good strategy, and I think he's done that here again. Factor
P4.
J. Yeah, P4 for him. He didn't qualify all that spectacularly, but qualified just well enough. And he's making that strategy work. Take a look at Michal Litwinski here as he rolls on down the straight. Maximovic, we were talking about the IEC guys not pitting yet, but Maximovic, she is going to come in to the pits and get that fuel topped off, most likely to the end, you would assume. Not for IEC, it would be silly to do anything else.
We'll see where he comes out. Really
stop for Coral, maybe he's finally going to be fueling to the end here.
We got to see where Juno comes out in relationship to, what's his name, I'm sorry. Spencer Brown, because that was the other one's.
Very good point, Noah. Maximovic and Brown are going to be the two that are going at it here. As you see Maximovic tumbling down the order. Oh, they are going to be pretty close here. Here comes Spencer Brown down the straight. Maximovic is going to be coming right out right there, right in front of Brown. So these two are going to tango. Here we go, Spencer Brown right in behind Maximovic as we get things going. Maximovic gonna have a heavy car there, but does have fuel to the end.
I think those are gonna be our leaders in a bit here.
It's interesting to see too how effective those fuel-saving cars are, because I believe blue balls are also fuel-saving, if I'm not mistaken. So Phobos got 68 liters of fuel. That's 29 laps listed for him. If we look down the order at some other teams, Will Duncan has 94 liters of fuel, and that's 31 laps, so it really puts into perspective just how much fuel they save with that fuel-saving strategy. So looking at Will Duncan's fuel after that stop, he's got 30 laps. He's good to go for the rest of the race, so came out in 23rd. Probably not the position he wants to be in, but definitely not
the
worst.
And I think now we know that it did not work out for Hayden Segovas today.
Yeah, it definitely didn't work out for Hayden Segovas. But, I mean, it's not entirely over for him just yet. He's fueled to the end at the very least. There will be more pit stops, and he is 77 seconds from first. But, you know, all the guys in front of him are within 30 seconds of him. So maybe if they take another pit stop, it will be all right. So we've got a lot of people coming into pit now. Fonte and Mars are showing up on the pit boards right now. Fonte not all that relevant to the race yet, even though she
anymore.
Was leading for a while.
Yeah, I think that early pit also kind of screwed her over in this race.
Very true, as we see Fonte just now starting that pit.
Still have the fastest lap, but sitting in 23rd.
Indeed. Japheth Barahona now coming into the pits, as is Jedi John. So positions 1 and 2 coming on in. That gives Madison Brown the lead of the race. Oh, heads up, here comes Factor J. Almost out of nowhere, Segovas is going to have to throw a big block for his teammate here. And that he does! It's a big block for Hayden Segovas. I think Madison Brown is going to stay out in front and lead this race. Excellent teamwork there by Hayden Segovas to allow Madison Brown to keep the lead of this race. And now Litwinski is right up the backside of Factor J. Brilliant team
race. Did Barahona fuel to the end?
Barahona, I would assume, fueled to the end.
He gets out of pits already, and he's in 7th, so...
Oh, wow. Very good look IEC. Very, very good look for IEC. He does have fuel to the end.
And then the non-IEC driver fell. So that definitely worked out for them.
Yep, fuel saving at a track like this where you're gonna have a lot of stops is big. Very, very big. Still some really interesting battles here as Factor J is gonna be just about side by side with Madison Brown as they come down the straight. We'll see if Segovas throws another big block. As Brown is battling hard for the lead of this race. Down the inside goes Jay, and maybe Lewinsky's going to try and follow and make it a double overtake here, as we've got a big gaggle of cars, but I think Jay is going to make it happen this time, unless Segovas throws a massive swing in front of Jay, and it's not going to happen. And now Madison Brown is in danger of falling to Lewinsky as well. It starts to get a little bit dark here at Kyalami. Just as we expected, we knew the sun was going to start going down and the clouds were going to come on in. I can assume the drivers are still seeing this.
Yeah, I think they're saying it's going to rain tonight, but not during this race time. Should
be
fine.
Yeah, they are predicting a little bit of rain, but yeah, it really shouldn't become an issue. Maybe we'll see some little sprinkles towards the end of the race.
I mean, actually, when the haulers are here trying to pick up the cars, it's going to make it a little messy, but...
there goes Brown, past Juno Maksimovic. So the IEC driver falls down a position. Now we knew those
Kyle
two.
Tupper by getting by his teammate James Brown.
Excellent.
As we speak.
Good pass by Kyle Tupper there, but those two really not in the fight for much. And Spencer Brown has really opened up a gap from Maksimovic already here. It's almost a second after that overtake as the gaps start to spread out quite a bit here. It's fuel strategy really showing itself, rearing its ugly head. Nice. Alex Martin getting the call. Come on in. He's in fourth right now. Shreveheart have just stuck their nose in things quite a bit today. As far as, you know, being in the top 10, top 5, even leading for a few minutes, but they really haven't.
They should also probably come out around, I'm sorry, the just, but see if they come out right around that fight with Spencer Brown.
Yeah, that'll be interesting to see. Lewinsky, oh no, it's Lewinsky! How did Lewinsky get there? Oh, I think it's a spin in turn one. It's Michal Litwinski of IEC has spun out in the first corner, starting a new lap, and all the way down the order goes the IEC driver. That is heartbreak for Inter-Europol competition in an incredible race for them so far.
So I do think he'll be able to continue. He's just looking like he's looking for open track, but...
I do think so as well, unless there's something wrong or maybe a tire that... a little too hot to continue. That's also possible. I'm sure he'll get back on track, but it might have to be after a lengthy pit stop. That's not what you want to see if you're IEC. Definitely not. As we got some shit talk going on between Will Duncan, who, interestingly enough, just now passed Michal Litwinski on track.
Oh, man.
Yeah, that's a turn of events, for sure. And I'd like to take a second here just to appreciate how good this PCR car sounds. It is a beautiful sounding vehicle as we got word that Factor J is going to be pitting on in here. Out of first place, he somehow inherited the lead, but definitely needed to make a stop. Lakatos and Lakers as well are going to come in here. Lakers in fourth, Casey Lakatos is in third, so there'll be a bit of a battle in the pit lane between those couple as Lewinsky still appears to be beached. There's something not quite right inside the cockpit of that car. I think it's a flat spot tire or something. Yeah, really tough to see for IEC as they were having such a good day. They still are having a really good day.
Yeah, because in fifth, they have the defeat who's already pitted. So I think he's going to be taking over the lead here in a second, followed by Spencer Brown.
Yeah, he should definitely hop up there. He might still stay behind Madison Brown, I believe. We've got Tupper who's going to come into the pits as well. So Jay and Lakatos are in the pits, as is Lakers. So Madison Brown takes the lead. These three are gonna have a great scrap coming out of the pit lane. As Jay is already out, very quick stop for him. Jedi John also gonna come on in. He's had a quiet race, but he's looked decent all the way through, as they didn't need to stop for very long. Casey Lakatos, and he does come out pretty well. How did Colonel Fleabag get up here? That's my question. How's she in seventh?
She always makes her way into the fight somehow.
She does. And interestingly enough, here comes Maksimovic as well. So it could still be a good day for IEC when all is said and done, because Maksimovic is looking very quick compared to Brown and Lakatos, because they're both full of fuel now at this point. And I think I just might be seeing some raindrops here as well, Noah.
Yeah, I think the weatherman is wrong. I'm going to have to talk to Steve Durham about that after the race. But, yeah, we are seeing some raindrops on the track here.
Yeah. Yep, you can see it there on the windscreen for Maximovic. There are definitely some drops coming down. Again, we've got all-weather tires on these cars. Shouldn't be much of an issue. Jedi John is in the pits. He's been in the pits for a long time.
And that's
Jedi
right there.
John have an issue. This could be another dismal day for Jedi John. Normally when you see that wheel turned, it means he was trying to pull out and the engine just didn't fire. I think Jedi John is done.
Yeah.
I think we're
really
going
just
to have
bad.
An unfortunate
two
DNF. Still got Lewinsky sitting on the
maybe
edge of the
three.
Track. It could just be John having a really could just be John having a really long stop. I'm really not sure. That's definitely
there's no
not.
Reason for a stop this long. They don't need that much fuel.
I wouldn't think so. As Brown and Lakatos are scrapping really hard here for this position, almost too hard. As Lakatos lost a lot of time there, and now he's really under fire from Maximovic. We continue to see that pit stop timer tick for Jedi John. I don't think he's coming out. Colin Fleabag going to pit here as well out of seventh place. We asked how she was doing so well, and that would probably explain it.
That's probably how.
Pull the long run, but not quite working out. We've still got quite a few laps to go here as the rain starts to sprinkle on down. There is a chance for some light thunderstorms in the area. It really shouldn't affect the racing.
Rain's coming down a little bit harder now. You can see it coming down a pretty decent amount.
Can definitely see it sprinkling quite a bit as Jedi John is just perpetually going to show in the pit lane, I think.
Yep. Poor Jedi John. Always
a rough outcome for him.
Always something with him.
Yeah, always something wrong. Fleabag into the pits. Now here comes Maximovic. Is this going to be the time he makes the move? Jockeying for position with Lakatos. Now he's alongside. Down the inside goes Maximovic. Does he have wheels ahead? Lakatos going to yield and try to take the outside here. Who's got better drive off the corner? It's going to be Maximovic. Lakatos did almost go off, maybe slipping a little bit in the small puddles that might be forming here. So Spencer Brown is the next target for Juno Maximovic.
When are we going to see Madison Brown come in?
That is a really good question. The answer is now. I just got the pit call, did Madison Brown.
Oh, there we go.
So, we'll see who's the best in the wet weather. It really doesn't affect the driving style here all that much, but you definitely have to be a little bit later on the throttle. As Barahona re-inherits the lead here from Madison Brown, who drops into the pits. We'll see if anybody can catch Barahona at this point. My guess would have to be no. I don't know who's going to catch up to him.
I don't think so.
I think this could just be a slam dunk runaway victory for IEC. As we do indeed have an IEC sandwich, with Lewinsky still beached on the side of the track there. And, John still in the pit lane.
The 10-second gap, I think he's pretty much got it.
Yeah, and Lakatos, man, not a good day for Lakatos. Oh no, Factor J tumbling down the order. Do we have an issue here as well? Yeah, Factor J's beached on the exit of turn one. The champion could be out here. He's facing the wrong way. We'll see if he can get that engine to fire. I don't know if he's going to have much luck with that, though.
He's done.
And that is huge.
The champion.
Huge, huge,
gone.
Huge. And maybe we get some pitters here because of the wet weather. We'll see. Yep, we've got everybody coming on in here because of the weather. We're going to watch the entire field pour into the pits now. To change
this is
gonna tires
get crazy.
Here in the rain.
This is where it gets fun.
This could very easily get crazy. Or is it just going to be Barahona? No, so J-Man stays out.
Oh, wow.
Interesting. Well, now we see that they're getting the call again. Our race fuel monitor is kind of bugging out right now. It's saying everybody's getting the call to come in. We've seen a few cars take. That is something that's changed in Formula Dream this year. Cars do pit in when it starts raining. So Barahona down to third temporarily, but this could really shuffle the order. We got all these guys in the pits here. As we take a look here and wait for everybody to come on out.
This is getting crazy.
This is indeed getting crazy to see everybody rolling on into the pit lane. So it makes you wonder what exactly is going on here. As it sounds like we do have some finally coming on out with the new tires put on. Because I think Barahona is going to be in good shape, most likely.
Unless man, there's so much going on right now. I'm trying to keep up with the timing
sheets. There is a lot going on right now. Is that Barahona in again? Well, if everybody's in. Everybody is still coming in. It's a long stop as well. I'm really confused as to exactly what's going on. I didn't know the wet tires took that long.
First on my timing sheet.
Yeah, so don't show them at first. I didn't know the wet tires took that long to put on, but apparently they do. As someone just rolled on by, I'm guessing somebody unlapping themselves.
Now it's showing Spencer Brown in first in my timing sheet.
Yeah, well,
I have no idea what's going on.
That's just who's furthest up in their pit stall.
Yeah.
So everybody in the pits for now. Barahona gets out in fourth? With a lot of cars right around him.
What has this race turned to?
Does he? Yeah, the wet weather throwing an absolutely massive wrench into everything here. We've got a lot of cars just sitting there in the pits. And here they all come now. As there's an absolute exodus of cars coming out of the pits now. Barahona down in sixth of the rain piles. And so it obviously takes quite a long time to get those wet tires put on. That is what we've seen happen here, but now look at the race we're gonna have. As Factor Bacon somehow is all the way up at the top of the field in first.
What the hell? Madison Brown second after all that.
Yeah, Jedi John for some reason showing himself at the top of the pit lane, above the pit lane indicator, so it's good. He's moved out of the pit lane indicator and they finally figured out that maybe he's just a DNF at this point. As everyone did come in for the rain, and not a great stop, actually, by IEC, or anybody. Nobody really had a great stop. Nobody really even had a good stop. Now, I'm trying to figure out what the heck just happened.
Yeah, I'm also trying to figure out what just happened there. But, that was just so much happening at once.
That's the caveat you get when you got AI racing. That is how it usually goes. Look at all these cars just lined up. This is incredible.
Now they're all going to be fighting to the end.
Yeah, that's Colonel Fleabag up in front. And that is a lapped car for Barahona. He's going to move on past now. As Martin's probably also dealing with the same issue up in front of Barahona, trying to get past the lapped cars. As not even our pit lane timer can figure out what's going on.
No one really knows what's going on.
Well, we know that the cars went in for wet tires, but obviously there's a lot of variability in those stops. And
yeah,
I'd be interested to see. I need to pull up our little...
Barahona going twice there? Like, I didn't...
He must have. So... Maybe inters to wets, because there are inters and wets on these cars. So maybe just had to switch on to full wet tires, but I don't see much of a spray coming off these cars yet.
No.
I mean, maybe that'll help him in the
maybe they're expecting
future.
More, but...
Could be.
We're definitely going to have to talk with our local weather broadcaster, Steve Durham, about this rain. We were expecting just clouds, and this really threw a wrench in today's race.
Indeed. So, here we go again. Everybody just lit up red once again on my monitor. We've
they're
got more cars going in.
Everyone's coming back in.
Wow, it doesn't appear to be so. I mean, the good news is, when everybody comes in like that, the good news is that everybody's stops take the same amount of time, for the most part. So that's why we've still got a lot of close racing out here, but what is happening now with the weather? This is wild. I mean, Assetto Corsa just decided to say, screw you guys, basically, is what it said. It decided to make the most chaotic race we've ever seen here in Formula Dream, with the rain starting to come on down here. And somehow Barahona is 42 seconds off the lead. Not sure exactly
that's
what's happening.
Insane.
Bacon, Brown, and J-Man up here at the front, but these are your top three. Somehow, Barahona's best of the rest. Still two top tens for IEC, and Formula Dream handles rain in an interesting way. Is
very
all we can say at this point.
Yeah.
So here comes Nadu. He's got a chance to get past Fleabag now, who I think is a lap down. A couple cars a lap down at this point. Looking at some of the gaps is absolutely insane.
Yeah, this is the craziest thing that we've ever seen in Formula Dream.
Yeah, oh, Madison Brown is really closing the gap on Bacon now. Maybe a mistake up front from Factor Bacon.
It's top three, and then the next after that is 30 seconds back.
Yeah. That is nuts. So here comes Brown. Oh, and speaking of Brown, Spencer Brown and David Lakers have both spun it here in 7th and 8th, and we've got more cars off to the side here in the wet weather. It's wet weather chaos, which everybody likes to see. But everybody, I guess, likes to see it except for Lakers and Brown, as they both spun it. And speaking of Brown, he was having a great race until now.
Yeah, very good opening race until then. That's really unfortunate for the area team.
So some wet weather.
Both the new teams experiencing a lot of emotions in today's race, both joy and pain. So they get all of it.
Welcome to Formula Dream is all I have to say about that. If you're worried about experiencing joy and pain, you will experience a lot of joy and a lot of pain. Probably more pain than joy. Probably more pain.
Yep.
Well, here comes Madison Brown for MMM, who will be very happy to have a good outcome here. We'll see how that goes. Interestingly enough, it looks like everybody is fueled to the end. As Lakers
back in the pit.
Into the pits after they had their incident. So here comes Brown. Maybe time to see a move by Brown on Factor Bacon as they roll on down the pit straight. I think Brown's probably going to get him if she plays her cards correctly here. So down the inside goes Madison Brown. Factor Bacon, known to be a bit of a dirty driver sometimes, but he does just concede the position there very gentlemanlike. Maybe he's learned after his previous mistakes. So Casey
Licata's
gonna
talk too soon. He's going to come back here.
Yeah, probably shouldn't talk too soon, actually. Also, interestingly enough, we did get Litwinski back going. Yeah, so he is still rolling here.
Two laps down.
Yeah, only two laps. And you never know with the garbage that happened already in this race. We could definitely see something crazy happen. So it's James Brown in P9, Martin in 10th, Wynn in 11th, and there are the red names again. Are they pitting again?
This is insane. They got...
Here come a few drivers into the pits. Come. We are experiencing the pit lane craziness again. And so Barahona didn't get called in, interestingly. So a lot of these drivers were drivers that I don't think went in the first time. I think they avoided the chaos that happened. We've got a fastest lap for Madison Brown in the wet. And Alex Martin and James Brown, speaking of Brown, we've got three Browns on track, and one of them has just taken out Alex Martin, it appears. So James Brown has knocked Alex Martin into the gravel. Interestingly enough.
That's two Browns down.
That is two Browns down indeed. As Casey Licata appears to have called it a day, which I can't really blame him for. So Madison Brown now pulling out a decent lead as Ziviello. How did Ziviello get to fifth?
Wow.
Insane result for Ziviello.
And then saying we might be seeing an early season cut of James Brown. They gave him a chance, but already costing the team money.
They did indeed give him a chance, and maybe even some penalty points as well. James Brown did appear to be the culprit there, the way he was speared into the side of Alex Martin like that. So we are in lap number 38 out of 45 of this race.
Will Duncan up to 8th after starting last.
Yeah, Will Duncan is indeed up to 8th. That's incredible. Maksimovic in 9th. We're watching Barahona now, who's far separated in 4th. Factor Bacon's also... Oh, no! J-Man hits Factor J! They seem to both be going fine, but... Oh, we almost had a big issue for P3 and Jeffrey J-Man. We cut just at the right time to see them smacking into each other. The sun is going down here. Maybe the visibility is starting to be an issue, but look at that view. It's absolutely beautiful, the view into the South African sunset like that is... Got some thunderstorms starting to rumble here. But still some good racing. Big lockup from J-Man. He's struggling big time here to keep that car on the road. Maksimovic as well, giving a good battle to Will Duncan in the PCR up ahead. As I see some red names once again, let's see who it actually is that gets called in this time. It always tends to be a couple and then really nobody else. And maybe it's actually nobody this time, as they are setting off the fireworks here. in South Africa on the start-finish straight. Celebrate the opening of the Formula Dream season. Now the sun's starting to go down. Here comes Maksimovic, possibly around Will Duncan. Down the inside he goes, trying to take P8, and I just think he's going to make it happen. Here goes Maksimovic, and he takes position number 8 away from Will Duncan. So, Noah, what do you make of this? What's going on here?
I don't know if the teams really know what to do. If they don't know if the rain's going to get harder. They don't know if they need to go back to inters. They don't know if they should stay in the full wets. And it's just a lot of data trying to see which one's faster between the teams. And that's why they're only pinning a certain driver to see which one's the fastest, I think.
Yeah. Yeah, it really scrambles up my fuel monitor here. But I'd be interested to take a look at the pit counts and see if they're about equal. Now, they're really actually nothing crazy. We expected some teams to pit 3 times. I knew that it was possible that we could see some 4 stops as well. So we've got a lot of 3 and 4 stops. So I guess the pit calls really haven't been that crazy out of the ordinary. I don't know what happened with Barahona. Sometimes the AI just freaks out like that. He went in 6 times. And he's still in 4th. That's what's crazy about all this, is he's still in 4th, Jefet Barahona, after all of that.
Hayden Segovia's also made up some positions up to 16th.
Yeah, good for Hayden. Yeah, so James Brown and Alex Martin still a little bit too close to each other for comfort after the incident they had earlier. I wouldn't be surprised if James Brown got a 1 position drop penalty, as Nadu and Tupper, the teammates as well, are going to be battling quite a bit here. Wondering if anybody still has to come into the pits, looking at the monitor here. I would assume we'd be done with the pit stops at this point after everything that happened.
You never know, though. With the rain, they might come in the last lap. You never know.
It's a really tricky rain to look at, as I think we are going to have a few takers once again to come in and switch tires.
They're coming in again.
Yeah, it does appear to be so. Here come, it's a lot of the lower cars in the field, as Fleabag, Segovia, Tupper, and Nadu have gone in, and they've just rolled through. You know what else it could be? It could be drive-through penalties, interestingly. So if you cross the white line of the pit lane, the game can give you a drive-through penalty. Because you saw Fleabag, she really just rolled right through the pits there. Wasn't even really a stop, so it's very possible that these cars are getting drive-through penalties. Or maybe, since there are all these lap cars, it could be a penalty for ignoring blue flags. It's also a possibility, just thinking about how the AI works in Assetto Corsa. So that could be part of your answer. Look at this absolute conglomeration that's happening here in the middle sector. And it's definitely raining harder in the middle sector than it is up on the front straight. It's just a lot of things going on here. It looks like we're going to have a couple more cars roll through the pits. I'm not sure who it's going to be. We're going to have to take a look and see who's deciding the pit here. As yes, look at all these cars just rolling on through the pit lane.
That makes no sense.
And they don't even stop. They just go through. It's like they've been given a drive-through penalty, which is the only thing that I could imagine is actually happening here, is a drive-through penalty. I would have to venture to guess that that's what's happening. So, the game must have assigned some drive-through penalties for whatever reason, but we don't mess with that kind of thing, so the drive-through penalties are kind of out of our control. It's all within the game's control, but it's really made for a wild race here. As we are getting close to the twilight of it, we've only got a few laps left to go. It's Madison Brown in the lead, and uh-oh, there's Jeffrey J-Man! That is P3! It could be a podium for Jefet Barahona if J-Man can't get it back going here within the next 50 or so seconds. And here is yet another wrench thrown into a wild race.
Oh,
Barahona is
going to
be sprinting, as the fireworks in the background are just gorgeous there. But Barahona is going to be sprinting his way to the final part of this lap here. You see the fireworks off in the distance, but this one ain't quite over yet. We've still got time for some more fireworks. As J-Man is in the pits, we'll see how long it takes him to come out. He's going to get that spare car going, but I think Barahona's going to beat him. We're going to have a battle for P3, quite possibly here, as Barahona rips on through. J-Man going to lose a spot to Ziviello as well, so it could be an unexpected P5 or top 5 for PCR. And oh my word, can this get any more entertaining? It's lap 44, we've got one left to go here. as it's just going to be, bar owner's just going to be saying, please, let's keep it on track. Race. This has been absolutely been absurd. Alex Martin gets past James Brown for 20th place, but oh wow, it doesn't get any more wild than this. Ziviello now has lost a spot to Keelan Wynn. As we've got a couple tight battles here, somehow still. After all that's happened, Fleabag is fighting for her life. She's got about six cars just absolutely crushing her from behind. And the good news is we've got some big gaps, so we'll be able to go in and watch those races. Look how dark it's getting here, too. You can really see those thunderstorms starting to roll in here at Kailami.
Yeah, it's going to get bad tonight.
It is quite possibly going to get pretty nasty here, as Madison Brown is behind some back markers here. But I don't think she's really going to be under any threat at all for Factor Bacon. Barahona is just now completing the second to last lap, and we are going to head to the final lap. It's Madison Brown starting her final lap of the race here in Formula Dream, trying to go down the inside here. She sees Kyle Tupper there on the outside. Oh, you better be careful, Madison. You better be careful. Kyle, could be contact here. You would hope not. And they do get through it. Okay. Nope. Oh, man, nice, scary stuff there is. Brown did get past Fleabag as well. Oh, you hear a big thunderclap there in the background.
And we see the pit stops light up again.
Yes.
What if they come in on the last lap?
Somebody has possibly gotten a drive-through. They will still cross the line in the pits, which is interesting enough. Who is going to go through? Coral has run through the pits, and that's it. All it was Coral, who's already way down, and he's just going to go in and, I think, call it a day. So here comes Japheth Barahona. He'll be starting his final lap here in not too long. We see it light up once again. So what's going to happen? Who's been given a penalty is my question. Could it be the leader? Because they have flashed red, but they haven't come in at any point. We'll see what happens here with Madison Brown. I don't think that's going
to
be the case.
Madison Brown has to come in. She could get pit passed. She has to go pit speed by factor back. That'd be crazy.
That would be crazy. Barahona's tumbled down the order. What's happened here? Why is Barahona in the pits? Why are all these cars pitting here at the end? Madison Brown has won the race.
Oh my
Bacon
gosh,
has spun
dude.
It into the pit wall. He's in second place. He's put in the pit wall. His race is over already, so it doesn't matter. Jamin and Ziviello are still battling here.
What is this?
What is going on? Fonte is right behind Ziviello. Gonna be a chance for a final lap overtake here. Oh my word, it's unbelievable. It's absolutely unbelievable. So here comes Fonte. It is so dark here as well. You can't see anything hardly. So here comes Fonte down the final corner, down the final straight. Does she get the position from Ziviello for fifth place? It's been oh so close all the way to the end here. Here comes Fonte looking for a chance down the inside. Is this going to be a last second overtake for fourth? Looks like Ziviello's just going to be able to hold her off, but they're going to be side by side coming to the line, and they finish in fourth and fifth. What a close finish. Oh man, Barahona has had one of the most wild races I've ever seen in really any category. As Bot Brooknell also has a chance to get past Steve Durham here at the finish, but I don't think there's going to be enough room to make it happen. As Barahona is in that pack as well, he'll come home and finish sixth. Still a good result for Barahona, but absolutely wild what has happened here with some of these cars as they roll in to finish the lap in the pit lane for some reason. That makes
Again,
a lot of sense.
Why not?
Yeah, because why not? The last car on track is Marcelo Mars. All he's got to do is just come home and finish. Other cars are still on track, but they are all done on their cooldown laps at this point.
Because they were smart and decided not to just pit. You know.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Well, it's an interesting race, but looking up and down the order, I don't really see anything that's too terribly surprising as they come in to complete the cooldown lap. We've got Bacon still in the sidewall there, so... Wow.
He's just enjoying his time.
Yeah, he is enjoying his time. Wow. Noah? Thoughts?
Yeah, was intense. That was an unexpected finish to that race. We expected just some clouds, but that rain really shook things up at the end. Like, it was just unbelievable.
Yeah, I think we had some tire switching. We had a lot of guys have car problems and go into the pits. It was absolutely insane from start to finish and definitely provided some entertainment. Give you that much.
Yeah, what a fun first race.
Well, we look through the top six. All separate teams. No team is repeated in the top six, interestingly enough. The only teams that didn't make a top 10 are Central United, and Area didn't make a top 10 either. Area had a rough go of things, I think, as it stands. So we'll go ahead and go through our order here.
No,
the
they
race
did.
Winner. The race winner is Madison Brown in Lushek's MMM. Second place is Factor Bacon. Third place is Jeffrey J-Man. That'll round out your podium. Not all that unexpected there. In fourth was Felicia Ziviello. Fifth, Mallory Fonte. Again, all people that were running up towards the front, although Felice did make an absolute tear towards the end. He started in like 17th. Good chance for driver of the day for him as we continue to look here. As Barahona finishes 6th, Wynn finishes 7th, Maximovic 8th, Jay 9th, Will Duncan in 10th, a top 10 for PCR. They've ended up having a really good day after it didn't quite look like it would be. Hayden Segovson 11th, Spencer Brown 12th, Colin Fleabag 13th, and Noah, I'll let you go ahead and take the rest of the order from P14 on down.
Finishing P14th was Steve Durham. Finishing P15 was Bob Brook. Finishing 16th was Josh Fobo for Blue Balls Motorsports. Finishing 17th is Marcelo Marsh for Rock Racing, followed by Kyle Tupper and his teammate Noah Nadeau for Central United Motorsports. Finishing 20th was Alex Martin for Shreveport. Finishing 21st from Central United was James Brown, followed by David Lakers. Finishing 23rd was Kroll. Finishing 24th was Mikhail Litwinski, my bad. Finishing 25th was Casey Lakatis, who got a DNF, and 26th was Jedi John, also a DNF.
Indeed. So, Noah, any final comments on the race today?
What an insane race today was.
Yeah, that was nuts.
I don't know. No, but with that ending, it was just intense.
Yeah, we never really knew.
There's so much going on.
Never really knew where to look. Never knew what was going on. It's unbelievable. Only a few cars finished on the lead lap, actually. Only 1 through 7. We're on the lead lap when things were said and done. But that's what rain will do to a race. That's one thing we've discovered. There was a rain-torn race, and it caused all kinds of issues coming in the pits. A lot of crashes, a lot of mix-ups.
Croc could be the driver of the day. It's whoever gained the most positions, so we'll have to look into that. But Will Duncan did go from last to 10th. So
yeah, and you do have to be in the top 10 for that to take
effect. So he got right there. He got
the
10th.
Luckily enough, he did get right in there. So excellent result for Will Duncan. Brilliant stuff for the PCR driver. And wow, well, we'll see you on Wednesday at 6 p.m. Eastern time. Around about. Actually, I think we're doing an early race again on Wednesday, aren't we? We're doing 11:30, I believe, Noah.
Is that think correct? So.
Or maybe noon? So we will have another...
That sounds correct.
Okay, we'll have another morning/noontime race coming at you next time. But until then, we appreciate you all for tuning in to round one. It was absolutely nuts. From start to finish, and it's not really what we expected to see. But, if you don't have any final comments, Noah, then on behalf of Formula Dream and Central United, I would like to wish you all a great rest of your day, a great rest of your night, wherever you are in the world, and we'll get these scoring results out to you very soon. And until next time, we will see you at Interlagos. Bye for now.
Have a great night, everyone.